Good Sunday morning. Ladies and gentlemen, we are about to get checked out of the hotel. We just loaded up both of our cars. And we're about to go get checked out of this place. Hey guys.
Hey, how are you?
Nice Kigu.
Oh, thank you. Hi, how are you? It's good. I'm
going to
grab a coffee.
This thing's cool. I don't know if I saw an MB.
I didn't mind, I told you. I'm okay with it.
Con, oops. All right, ladies and gentlemen, it is about, what time is it right now? It is about 3:40 right now. There's really not much more going on. I'm about to head out. Long drive back. I actually have to. I'm actually having dinner with some family tonight, and then after I get back home, I'll give my closing spiel and stuff. But yeah, the last convention of the year is coming to a close. My convention year is coming to a close, and not a whole lot really happened today. small convention, pretty much everyone starts going home on Sunday. People are starting to head into the main events hall for closing ceremonies as well. I might stay for closing ceremonies, so. When this came on, gave a collective groan.
Yeah.
And I don't know why. Here and there and everywhere.
Yeah. That was a torturing show. I don't know why.
Was it really?
To be honest with you, I wasn't really that into it when I was young.
Oh. Nobody knows more about yourself than you do.
I hear.
You're the first to know.
I hear the theme music's popular.
The theme music was okay, but the show itself, I wasn't really that
so easy to take. You can trust the X-Lax family of laxatives. Chocolate and the unflavored pill, because they contain phenolphthalein.
Chocolate laxatives?
Which is medically proven
really?
Effective. Everybody needs help now and then.
I was writing paper on the PC, and it was like beep, 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 beep. And then, like, half of my paper was gone. And I was like, it devoured my paper. It was really good paper. And then I had to write it again, and I had to do it fast, so it wasn't as good. It's kind of... It's a bummer.
Apple.
I'm Ellen Feist, and I'm a student.
Okay.
Hi, I'm Robert Lee. I own Coleman Liquidation. I sell mobile homes. I'm not going to waste your time. I'm going to tell it just like it is. These are mobile homes, not mansions. They come in two pieces. If that's what you're looking for, that's what I got. They're used. Some of them have stains. We cover that up. She decorates them. She sells them. These guys help me move them. A bouncer in Birmingham hit me in the face with a crescent wrench 5 times. And my wife's boyfriend broke my jaw with a fence post. So if you don't buy a trailer from me, it ain't gonna hurt my feelings. So come on down to Coleman Liquidation and get yourself a home. Or don't. I don't care.
I don't care. I don't know.
Good morning, Felix. This good morning.
Oh God, again. What does that have to do?
That's one less thing to dust.
Ew. Wait, does that mean she gave the cat the hot sauce?
Oh. Don't you dare look back. Just keep your eyes on me. I said you're holding back. She said shut up and dance with me. I love this song.
Oh, yeah, the boys are like... Fuckers, fuckers.
That song.
Well done.
That's a good song.
Well done.
Constipation can be a
oh god.
And when constipation occurs, it's interesting to see just what doctors consider important about a laxative they might use or recommend. Well, a majority of the doctors we heard from said they wanted a laxative that is effective, gentle, close to natural active. A medicine that can be used with complete confidence. Now, X-Lax has been used with complete confidence by many doctors and millions of people over the years because pleasant-tasting chocolate of X-Lax is effective. Overnight, it helps you toward your normal regularity.
X-Lax
is so gentle, so close to natural acting, there's no upset, no discomfort. So whenever your normal regularity is interrupted,
I've been through what they're talking about.
The laxative that helps you toward your normal regularity, gently, overnight, X-Lax.
Hi, it's Fitz with
Fettuccine, linguine, martini, bikini.
Yay. My
goodness.
I like square butts and I can't.
Oh, God.
Backbone book impress the crowd shouts. All the ladies stare. And those pants are square. Swinging through the seaweed tangles. Is a butt with short right angles. Now, SpongeBob, I want to get rich, y'all. Get a toy and a kid's meal.
Booty is booty.
Buy an adult value meal and get a BK kid's meal with a SpongeBob toy for 99 cents.
Oh, this was a commercial?
Yes. It was a commercial. It was a commercial.
Oh, God. Oh, please don't let this be X-Lax again. Please, God, don't let this be X-Lax again.
Attention, please. It is now 4 o'clock. This panel has started. Please continue to wait. Thank you.
Wow. That was, well, I don't know what that was.
I have no idea.
When any other
oh, for God's sake.
You're the first to know. But what you don't want is one that tastes like a laxative. Now try orange-flavored X-Lax Instant Mix. Oh. The liquid laxative with a fresh, bright taste. Orange-flavored X-Lax contains phenolphthalein, which is medically proven effective.
It's gentle. And so easy to take.
Gentle, orange-flavored X-Lax Instant Mix.
Good God.
Everybody needs help now and then.
Enough with the laxatives, please.
Since Tom has to get back home and his time is limited, we all of your questions, comments, concerns are important. But can you, if you have a priority that involves guests, yes, which goes from community guests or VIPs, please try and have those at this point so Tom can answer them.
Yes, Tom is one of our long distance speakers.
Oh, okay, never mind. You had told me this earlier, but I guess... Okay, so never mind. So whatever order your questions, comments, concerns are, please start away.
Renegade stage, similar to other conventions for like people who may not be DJs officially, but something like that.
So you're talking about something like how BronyCon is Renegade stage?
Yes.
That is a plan I have in the future, though it's more of a logistical challenge than anything. Is, I'll be perfectly honest, the reason we don't have it is I don't have enough staff to pull it off. I don't want to present a product to all of you that is substandard. Some things I know we've been done this year may need improvement, but I feel at this point, if I'm putting something forward, I want to be able to put a team behind it that can give you the best possible product. So that's the answer. So it is in the plans of my, trust me, I have a long list of things I want to do, and that is on the list. Because one of the things I love about this convention is we can give, like, I hate to say the term, but little people or like not as well-known people that chance to actually get in front of an audience. So I want to do that. That is on my want list. Thank you.
Hi there.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
So just an observation that I made at the beginning of this panel, something that I noticed. This is your fifth year, correct?
Yes.
There was a running joke all the way through, leading up to and during the first convention in 2013, that it was your fifth year convention. That was how you guys announced it. And I just felt I should point that out to you, that you actually made it to 5 years.
Now that was DerpyCon Space.
Yeah.
That changed in 2014. So DerpyCon's been around since the mid-50s.
Oh!
We're actually on year like 75.
I'm way off then, never mind. I just wanted to point that out. Thanks, guys.
No problem, thank you.
Now, Tom, you have a question you want to pose to the audience.
Okay, here. This is a simple show of hands question. Basically, we have a certain amount of funds here to bring guests. What do you think the bigger priority is? Show of hands, voice.
First of all, voice actors. What's more? Is that more important? Okay, that's a sign. Versus our community guests. Is voice actors the more important to you as an attendee for guests? Raise your hand.
What's community guest?
Charles Dunbar, the cosplay guest, the artist guests, the Kamiku girls, Fiora on the side here.
I like this person.
All right, I got an idea. And community guests. Guests don't matter to you either way. You would come if we had no guests.
Interesting comments.
Okay.
All right, cool. And also just on a general idea, one thing we're also trying to attempt to do this year and that we did last year was we asked, what would you like video game voice actors? That's why this year we had a Johnny and Keith
Did you like that we decided to bring other things that weren't just straight up anime voice actors? Just to get general, like, yeah! Alright, cool. So now, so you would like the idea in the future within our, within budget, we can't get everybody, but within budget, would you like us to continue this idea of still having anime voice actors, but also having ones who do video games and all that other stuff? Yeah.
We will do everything we can to keep bringing variety to this con.
Oh, God.
I'm not saying we have any requests or suggestions or anything.
Yep.
Just leaving that there for your...
Thank you, thank you. Thank you, Dr. Andrew. Let's give them a round of applause, by the way. All right, that's enough.
No, we can always give more applause to the AV people. They never get enough thanks.
So right now, I know you guys probably want the free stuff and then get the hell out.
So, free stuff.
I do have a very special announcement that I do want all of our staff that are in the room to come up on the stage and stand right behind us for this special announcement. Yes, here they come. Oh boy, here they come.
Should we be scared?
Oh, someone's taking a picture of this.
So, I'll take the lead and then Anthony, you continue.
First of all, let's give them a round of applause.
Applause for some of the people who aren't here who are helping put everything back into the its crates and everything, so people are not here.
By the way, they volunteer, they help out, they might get a room, they might get some food, but you know what? Well, we do treat them well, and I'm so glad that you guys are here. Thank you.
But we're not done yet. We have news that we hate, we have to say.
Oh, God.
2019 will be the last year of DerpyCon.
Wow.
You better be trolling. In Morristown. At this
we can't anymore.
This is an announcement that I've been waiting for the last, well, actually, believe it or not, since I laughed here last year.
You laughed here last year?
You laughed here last year.
Sorry, it's getting a little emotional there because of my acting.
Oh, wow.
Where are you going?
I was in the moment and you guys are ruining it. So, you guys are probably going, where the hell are we going now?
Please tell us.
Let the man talk.
Hey, let him speak.
Finding this venue when we started our first con took 18 months, and we were able to find a new venue within 6 months. And this is why I kind of was like, I read your feedbacks from both 2017 and 16. I read all your complaints, and most of the complaints are regarding the venue. I kind of had a final straw, and she's my witness. I almost had it. And we made the executive decision.
Oh, God, here comes the thing.
It was a very timely process. It started back in November, and then we found a place in February. And then, of course, through negotiations and all, we were able to get an agreement signed by May. And believe it or not, these are the same people that I worked with getting here. And are we going so far? Well, I actually meant to put jokes things on here, Dr. Andy, but I failed. We're not going to Atlantic City. We're not going somewhere far.
We're not going to the Javits Center.
We're not going to Somerset.
We are going to New Brunswick. Yes! Yeah!
How far away is that?
We are going to be at the Hyatt Regency New Brunswick in DerpyCon 2020.
Wow.
The dates have already been set, so I guess I should just say it at this point since I am building the hype. It's going to be on our weekend of Halloween, October 31st.
Woo! Halloween. DerpyCon just became Halloween Con.
Halloween of Derpy of 2020.
Just became so Halloween Con.
Steph, thank you for coming up, but we do have some video, we do have some pictures of the venue that we want to show you, and we'll have that scrolling as we go through our raffles because we do have to hurry up and pack up. Thank you guys.
They freaking trolled us. They trolled us. They trolled.
So Regency in New Brunswick, New Jersey.
New Brunswick.
That's a bit south from
now,
from
when
here.
We searched
yeah.
for a venue.
That's south from here.
Yeah. We wanted to be exactly where we are. We want to have accessibility to transportation. We want to have places for you to get some food. We also want places for you to enjoy the convention as well as the town. New Brunswick is kind of that different compared to here. You have a local New Jersey transit and an Amtrak station at the New Brunswick station.
Wow.
That station may be quite
familiar
to you if you went to a convention in Somerset. This is our large ballroom right here. This ballroom is going to be split, actually. It's going to be main events and dealer's room.
Oh, wow.
And ladies and gentlemen, I will confirm this to you because I made sure that I made sure of this before we even did anything. We have the entire hotel.
Woo!
So, we have plenty of room of expansions. Ladies and gentlemen, no more panel four.
No more panel four.
Panel 4.5.
Panel 9 3/4.
So what's the dates for next year again?
So remember, guys, you guys have to remember this. We still have next year here, so we have another year to deal with no room noise complaints. So the next year is going to be October 25th through the 27th.
Oh, wow.
Okay.
So we're going to be the weekend before Halloween.
Okay.
So it's going to be fun and exciting. Hopefully we can see you then. Registration should open up by Thanksgiving.
And even the local venues, please next year be as equally as kind this year to this venue. Hey, they're people just like you and me.
Thank you all for coming. We'll see you next year. Have a good night.
Yeah. I get a Kauai box.
Kauai box.
What is this one?
It's candy. You may never know what different Japanese candy you might get.
Yeah, he won that in a raffle.
Oh yeah, right.
Look at that.
I was the one that was wearing that
clothes. Oh yeah,
I'm wearing mine.
Look at these two dorks.
Hey there.
I won.
That was good.
Yeah.
Oh, you got Japan box.
They freaking trolled us with it saying, oh, no, she's going to be the last year to DerpyCon. But the thing is that I may not be able to come next year because I'm planning on going to Ponyville Satterfest next year.
Hey, I might see you there.
You're going to Satterfest?
I'm hoping to run panels there.
It's a terrible day for a con.
Well,
it's the week before Halloween.
It doesn't matter. Like, there are other Halloween parties.
Will make you happy,
really. But 2020 is on Halloween.
You know what they say about hindsight.
Hindsight is 2020.
Oh, I see.
I'm excited. I think having it on Halloween would be a lot of fun.
It's like a couple days after.
I do agree that voice actors, like, they're really expensive and they take up con resources.
The reason why they were
because telling like superhero cosplayers they can't wear masks.
What?
Yeah.
Oh yeah. That.
We are gonna go to the vendor hall to help Christine and Jenna load their vendor booth stuff out.
That's dumb.
Okay. That's dumb. All right, so folks, that is the end of DerpyCon 2018.
Yep.
Next year, I'll probably not be here because that's probably around the time that Ponyville Cyberfest is going to be. This guy won. A Japan box at the raffle at the closing ceremonies.
Yeah, I'm planning, since I wasn't able to go to CiderFest this year, I am planning on doing it next year, but that means I will have to give up my bid for DerpyCon next year, because it's probably around the same time, because CiderFest usually happens around Halloween, so. Yeah, so if you do come to DerpyCon next year, you're going to have to fend for yourself, I'm afraid.
Yeah, that's fine. I'm used to it.
Yeah.
Alright. Yeah, but I'm going to hang a little longer, and I'm gonna probably see what's up.
Okay. So. I have to book it, so.
Yep.
I'll see you in 2019.
Yep, 2019. I guess for BronyCon, if there a space for my best friend going up on 7-3, he wants to come for the last BronyCon.
You're gonna have to talk to Jake about that, because he wants to be in charge of the hotel room next year. I'm pretty much done hosting the room for BronyCon, because that's kind of a task.
I hear you.
So he's gonna be in charge. You're gonna have to talk to him about it.
Yeah, no problem.
All right. Going home back to Pennsylvania. I just got back home. It's about 8:46 right now. I had some dinner with my parents, my grandmother, and back home. Some stuff to reflect on this weekend. It was a lot less busier this year than it was last year at DerpyCon. I think probably the main cause for that is because next week is Anime NYC, and a lot of people chose that over this convention. So, I don't know. I was happy to see some people that I knew this weekend. I saw Avocado Smash, who was the Discord at some of the events at BronyCon. Got to see Lil Shy, FIM, and Draconite, all both on Anthology, Opponents of the Anthology. We had our panel on Friday. I was pretty happy with that. We got a little bit of higher attendance this year than we did last year. We were also at a much earlier in the convention than we were last year. We were also in a different room. Also a pretty small room, panel room number four. It's basically a closet, so I am just, oh, Shadow. I'm really tired. I don't know what to say. I'm gonna try to keep this brief, but this year was, I had a fun time at the conventions that I went to. It started out with Nashicon in Columbia, South Carolina. Got to see, obviously, Sarah Serendipity Cosplay. Sadira, Drowning in Rice and Destructive Doll, among others. It's a great convention. It's pretty small, but I mean, you know, I got to see a lot of different cosplayers there, but most importantly, what I mainly was there for was to see friends who I don't get to see very often. So I think this sets the record number of times of the number of times I got to see them this year. GnashiCon, BronyCon, and then for the wedding for Destructive Doll and Johnny Rice's wedding a couple weeks ago. So I was very happy to get to see them. They're always fun to be around. And then ZenkaiCon in Lancaster, Pennsylvania. Overall, I had a fun time there. I got to hang out with also a lot of great people. This is the first time that Chief Hunter 1 got to go to ZenkaiCon. Also, Lady Ava got to showed up. I got to hang out with her a little bit and talk with her. And then my trip to Japan. That was a lot of fun. It certainly exceeded my expectations on, like, what the country is all about. It's very, very, very efficient. They're very polite, and I can't wait to go back in a couple of years. And then BronyCon. That's always fun, as it always is, and I just. Of course, none of us were really expecting the announcement that they were going to make that it was going to be the last. It's going to be next year's going to be the last BronyCon. So, but I'm kind of happy about that because that means that takes me off the hook for having to miss 2020 because of the Olympics, and so because there's not going to be the BronyCon in 2020. And then. Obviously, I went to ColossalCon East as well. I did not vlog it. My friend Chief Hunter 1 did. I got to see, obviously, Lady Ava cosplay again. Got to talk with her about the gala video that I made. And then there's Deanna, Deja Vu D. I got to see her again. One thing about her is that she has kind of been off the radar ever since then. She said that she is not mentally in a good state, and I hope she's okay. She has taken down her Facebook page and her Instagrams, her private Twitter. Her public Twitter is still up, but she has not posted any updates there. So. I hope she's okay, Deanna. If you do watch her YouTube channel is also still up. So if Deanna, if you're watching this, please get well soon. We all care about you, and I hope you surface sometime soon because it's kind of a void when you're not there, and you're always a bundle of joy to be around, no pun intended, because she's the queen of the bunny bundles. And so, and then there's DerpyCon, last convention of the year. It was fun. It was pretty small. It was kind of not much really went on, because I mean everyone kind of is a day to go home, and it's the last day of the convention. A lot of people requested that a lot of events be held on Saturday. Nothing much held today. So, yeah. This year has been, again, a roller coaster for me. I had a fun year this year. I can't wait to do it again next year. I'm not sure what my next convention is going to be, but my guess is that it may be from Everfree Northwest in May. I may go back to ZenkaiCon next year, but only for one day, and also, and not planning on vlogging anything because, you know, it's one day. What's the point? So, and the reason why I'm only going one day next year is, or plan on going one day to ZenkaiCon next year is because they kind of, you kind of balked on the putting up of the hotel rooms. They sold out of hotel rooms for the convention within the first 15 minutes that they went up. So I was not able to get one, and so if anything, I'm only going to be able to go for 1 year, or for 1 year, for one day next year. And then there is going to be BronyCon. Last convention for BronyCon next year. And then it's going to be a 4-day convention next year. And then I'm hoping to get a room at the Kalahari for ColossalCon East next year. I hope to go all 3 days next year. I kind of feel a little bit better about that because I was kind of a little bit apprehensive about going this year because of last year I went and my grandfather passed away. But next year, I hope to go all 3 days and hopefully get a room at the Kalahari. Hopefully. We'll see. I'm looking forward to next year. This year has been fun. So, that's kind of the long and the short of it, and so, another convention year has come and gone, went by that quickly. I think this one went by quicker than previous years. Why does that happen? I don't understand it. Probably my next the next vlog you're going to be seeing is from Everfree Northwest in Seattle in May of next year. So, ladies and gentlemen, I want to bid you all farewell, a happy holidays, whatever you guys celebrate. You know who you are, and you know what you do. I bid you all farewell once again, and this is Red Card signing off for the final time in 2018. And here are some moments to reflect on from 2018 that will live with you as it did with me. Good night, and good buck. See you next year, guys.
And although we could return to our smaller roots, we feel if we did that, we would no longer be BronyCon. So instead, we want to send BronyCon out with the giant celebration it deserves. It's going to be a celebration by the community, for the community and of the community, of the friendships you've made, the adventures you've had, and the wonderful world you've helped bring to life. Take a look around, because every person in this room is an essential part of our community, our family, and we couldn't have done it without every one of you.
Gibson, the home plate umpire, motioning to both players.
Hard, Kiermaier, hard. Sliding, doesn't get it. Two-two delivery on the way in the air, right center field. They turn into watch. Hey!